Nairobi Urban Creators was established after the Habitat 3 conference, which took place in Quito in October 2016. And the Habitat 3 conference was, of course, focusing on sustainable urban development. And before that, we had done a lot of youth activities in relation to engaging young people in the process, in setting their priorities for what they would want or what they think is a sustainable city and their aspirations for the future. So Nairobi Urban Creators, the organization was founded after the conference in Nairobi, and the main motivation was to now engage young people in the implementation of the new urban agenda in Kenya. Because, before then, young people, of course, had been involved in shaping the document, giving their priorities. Now it was time for them to be involved in its implementation. After the Habitat 3 conference, of course, the very first thing we did as Nairobi Urban Creators is that we have a youth representation in what we call the National Habitat Committee, which is based in Nairobi, and it's an initiative by the State Department of Housing and Urban Development. And our youth representative there, of course, now contributed in drafting a popular version of the new urban agenda, which is a shorter version of the of the Quito document. So the popular version of the new urban agenda for Kenya highlights the priorities that Kenyan cities, that now the Habitat, the National Habitat Committee, together with stakeholders, agreed to are the priorities for Kenyan cities. So the main objective activity back then was to ensure that we are the voice of young people in the popular version and in the implementation framework. We even had a budgetary allocation for young people and activities that young people are supposed to carry out in the implementation. In terms of motivating young people, first of all, you have to be clear who you are going to motivate. Because you might find yourself motivating the wrong people. And so we invest a lot of time in defining who our members are going to be as Nairobi Urban Creators. We actually source most of our members from existing youth networks and youth organizations, and you find that these are people who are already involved in community work. They of course appreciate the efforts that organizations do in terms of making life better in communities. And so just like companies invest in the recruitment process, in having a functioning human resource department, as an organization, you also need to make sure that you look for the right membership. And then after now you have the right membership, you need to have a very clear goal and vision that will be like the driving force for these people who are behind you. So make sure that your vision and mission is clear. And then after that, because we are talking about young people, you have to link them to opportunities, because most of these young people are, of course, from organizations, there's something they do. So if you can present your organization as something that can help them get to the next level in whatever they're doing, then they become really helpful members of your organization. Because that is what we do with the Nairobi Urban Creators. We have members from different youth organizations who are, of course, involved in sustainable urban development, but in different activities. I would say social media has been a very integral, part of, what we do. And mostly it's through creating awareness about our events, people register on Facebook. So, we use social media to make sure that we reach diverse audiences, more than just the people in our mailing list. We are able to reach, government agencies, we are able to reach politicians. So the social media has, been an integral part of our campaign and has been really helpful in actually increasing the impact of what we do. Yeah, for anyone who is skeptical about involving young people in their processes, I would just like to say that is wrong, and time has shown that young people are creative, they are talented, and they actually come up with solutions that affect communities. So it's really good to involve, you know, the young in making decisions that impact the communities and societies.